गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू सोशल साइंस क्लास 7। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न यूनिट 2 हिस्ट्री पार्ट 3 एमर्जेंस ऑफ न्यू किंगडम इन नॉर्थ इंडिया। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सी कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ पालास टू कल्चर। द पालास वर अडहरेंट्स टू Mahayana school of Buddhism. There were generous patrons of the Buddhist temples and the famous universities of Nalanda and Vikramashila. It was through the missionaries that Buddhism was established in Tibet. The celebrated Buddhist monk Atisha, who reformed Tibetan Buddhism, was the president of Vikramashila Monastery. The Paulas also maintained cordial relations with the Hindus Buddhist state of Shilindars of Sumatra and Java. This overall contribution of the Paulas of cultures is presence. Under Pala patronage, a distinctive school of art arose called Pala art or Eastern Indian art. Pala artist style flourished in present day states of Bihar and West Bengal and also in present day Bangladesh. It was chiefly represented by bone sculptures and the palm leaf paintings celebrating the Buddha and other devotees. The Pala bone sculptures from this area played an important part in the spread of Indian culture in Southeast Asia. Are you clear, children? This all are presence in contribution of Palas to culture. Now we are going to see advent of Islam. In this lesson, we are going to see now advent of Islam. We are going to see Muslim came and established the kingdom in India. We will see the advent of Islam in India. It is started with the Arabs conquest of Sindh in AD 712. In AD 1001, Muhammad of Ghazni defeated Jayapala. In 1030, Muhammad of Ghor captured Multan. In AD, Pratihara Chauhan defeated Muhammad. In AD 1192, the Second Battle of Tarain is happening. Islam is a religious faith originated at the Mecca in America. The founder of Islam was Prophet Muhammad. The follower of Islam are called Muslims. Are you clear, children? Very good. An Islamic state, especially the one ruled by a single religious and political leader, was known as Caliphate. Caliphate means a representative of Prophet Muhammad. Two early caliphate were Umayyad and Abbasid. Both the Umayyad and Abbasid expanded their rule separately by their conquest and by preaching the principles of Islam. This all are advent of Islam. In the 8th century, India, the Arab present appear in the form of Muslim army that conquered the Sindh. But the further expansion was made impossible by the kings of Gangetic Plains and the Deccan. By the end of 9th century, with the decline of Abbasid Caliphate, the Arab garrisons in India and elsewhere threw off Caliphate's control and began to rule independently. The Turkish governor Alptecin was one among them whose capital and Ghazni. His successor and son-in-law Subukiting wanted to conquer India from the northwest, but only his son Muhammad succeed in this endeavor. Now we are going to see Muhammad of Ghazni. In AD 1997 to 1030, Muhammad of Ghazni, Muhammad is said to had concluded 17 raids into India. At the time, North India was divided into number of small kingdoms. One of them was Shahi Kingdom, which extended from Punjab to Kabul. The other important kingdom were Kannauj, Gujarat, Kashmir, Nepal, Malwa and Bundelkhand. The initial trades were against the Shahi Kingdom, in which it is King Jaipala was defeated in 1001. After his defeat, Jaipala immolated himself because he thought that his defeat was a disgrace. His successor Anandapala fought against Muhammad but was defeated in the Battle of Vaihind near Peshawar in 1008. As a result of his victory at Vaihind, Muhammad extended his rule over Punjab. The subsequent raids of Muhammad into India were aimed at bundling the rich temples and cities of North India. In 1011, he raided Nagarkot in Punjab Hills and Taneshwar near Delhi. Ruins of Somnath Temple. In 1018, Muhammad bundled the holy city of Mathura. He also attacked Kannauj. The ruler of Kannauj, Jayapala, abandoned Kannauj and later died. Muhammad returned with enormous riches. His next important raid took place in Gujarat. In 1024 AD, Muhammad marched from Multan across Rajputana and defeated the Solanki king Bhimadevan and bundler Anilwad. Muhammad is said to have sacred the famous temple of Somnath, breaking the ideal. Then he returned through the Sindh desert. That was his last champion in India. Muhammad died in 1030 AD CE. The Ghaznavid empire roughly included Persia, Transoxiana, Afghanistan and Punjab. This all are happening in this Muhammad of Ghazni period. Oh children, my dear children, you all are understood clearly about this lesson. Go through this lesson clearly. Thank you children. Have a nice day.